Come all ye noble ploughmen of courage stout and bold, who labour all the winter time through stormy winds and cold, to crown your fields with plenty and your farmyards to renew, that bread may not be wanted, we must use the faithful plough. So Adam was a ploughman when ploughing first begun, and the next that did succeed him, it was Cain, his eldest son. Some of this generation the calling now pursue, for we are all dependent upon the faithful plough. Says the ploughman to the gardener, count not your trade as ours, but walk your curious borders and gaze upon your flowers. If it was not for the ploughman, both rich and poor would rue, for they are all dependent upon the faithful plough. Behold the wealthy merchant who trades in foreign seas, to bring forth gold and treasure for those that lives at ease, with finest silks and satins and fruits and dainties too. They are all brought from the Indies by virtue of the plough. I hope that those who hear this will count in what is true, that we cannot sail the ocean wide without the faithful plough. For they must have beer and biscuits, plum pudding, flour and peas, for to feed the jolly sailor boys who plough the raging seas. Well, I hope there's none offended now with me for singing this, for it never was intended to be anything amiss. But if you consider it rightly, you will find out that it's true, that all the trades I've mentioned depend upon the plough. So come all you noble ploughmen of courage stout and bold, who labour all the winter time through stormy winds and cold, to crown your fields with plenty and your farmyards to renew, that bread may not be wanted, we must use the faithful plough.